Hey, welcome back. In today's video, we're going to talk about how to upgrade our Wi-Fi to go from this to this. Let's get started. Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. Today, we're going to review the TP-Link X68 wireless mesh system. It is a Wi-Fi 6 tri-band system. It is AI driven. It has three bands and two decos, covers 5,500 square feet. It also comes with optional TP-Link Home Shield service to protect your internal network. But how does it stack up against the competition? Well, let's jump right into it. All right, so let's get started with this unboxing here. On the back of the box, it details a pretty standard configuration of the X68s. And as we open this up, at first glance, the decos look nice. It's standard. You'll see that the decos are very well packaged. And my first impression of it is it's pretty lightweight. It's like a hard plastic material. It doesn't have a lot of weight to it. It doesn't feel premium to me, but that's not a major concern. The design is pretty standard and simple here. You have them the blacktop design, and then on the bottom you have another round for ventilation, and then it has some standard ports here. It gives you two Ethernet ports, one and two here, and then a standard power outlet. And since I had three of these from Costco's, I had to decide which one to use as my primary router. Luckily enough, this Wi-Fi system does not matter which one you use. You can use any of them, so that's a plus. The box on the side has a nice detailed quick setup guide. Download the app, turn off your modem, connect everything up, and plug it in. What else do we have in the box here? We have the standard power outlet for each device. You can see here, one thing I didn't like about it, it's a pretty bulky. It's a very bulky plug. I mean, I don't understand why they needed this giant massive plug, to be honest with you. I mean, this takes up a giant amount of space on my network rack. All right, guys, let's jump into the setup and design here. I spent some time setting up a nice diagram so that you guys could all visualize what our setup is going to look like, and it might be very similar for you. So let's get started. So first, we're going to start on the top left hand corner here where your internet feed comes in, and it's going to connect to your ISP modem. In my case, this is the Frontier Communications ONT box. From there, we're going to have an Ethernet wire that's going to connect to the first port of the Deco X68. The second port of the Deco X68 is going to connect to the network switch. This is going to allow everything on that network switch to have internet access, because the Deco X68 that's connected is going to act as a router. That's going to start handing out IP addresses to everything on that network switch. From the network switch, we're then going to connect one Ethernet port to any of the existing ports on the Deco X68s that are remaining. This is going to allow them to function at full capacity and provide at maximum output to all your wireless devices. This is what we call a wired backhaul system. This will complete a wired Ethernet backhaul system for our mesh Wi-Fi. This is extremely important because what it's doing is, instead of communicating with the other Deco devices using the Wi-Fi signal, it's using Ethernet to connect the other Decos together. This frees up another 5 gigahertz band to provide full throughput to all your other wireless devices. Now that we've established our wired backhaul architecture, let's move on to initial speed test. And you can see the speed is not horrible, but of course, now that I have a much faster internet connection, I'm not getting not even 10% of that speed using the Google Wi-Fi system. I'm getting about 73 megabits per second download and about 68 megabits per second upload. And this is on my new 800 by 800 fiber internet connection. So we definitely want to make the best use of that speed. So now let's dive right into the physical setup. First, I need to determine where my Ethernet wire is in my home. I'm using this Klein tool system to do testing between my two Ethernet wires. On the top, I'm connecting one side of the Ethernet wire. Here in my laundry room, I have the other piece of the Klein tools tester, and I have that wire connected to the Klein tools secondary piece. And then I'm gonna go down to my basement now, where all the wires for my home drop down, and I'm gonna connect the other side to an existing wire that's just hanging. Once I click the test button, the test needs to determine if it's successful. 1 through 8 needs to match on top and bottom. If it doesn't match, there's an issue that you need to fix, but that's for another video. Once we determine that we got the wires exactly where they need to go, we're gonna go ahead and now configure the setup. So let's move on to the configuration. Here on the app, you'll see that it says, let's begin. We're gonna go ahead and choose our X68, X36 device, and we're gonna go ahead and hit next. And it's gonna give you some basic instructions, you know, the power off your modem, power off your devices, and then hit next. and then it's going to tell you to plug everything in and then power everything back on. So let's go ahead and do that now. All right, everyone, downstairs in my basement, I've connected the giant bulky plug to my TP-Link, and the yellow Ethernet wire connects to my ONT's gigabit internet port. I'm going to power off both of the devices, and you're going to see when you power them back on, you're going to get this blue light from the Deco, and we're just going to go ahead and wait till the Deco has a green solid light. Once it has a green solid light, we can move on to the second step. The second step is to complete the wired backhaul system. On the second port of my main TP-Link, you're going to see a black wire, and we're going to go ahead and connect that to my existing Netgear managed switch. I've connected that to the far right port so I can easily identify which port is coming from the Deco X68, and this is going to allow all the other ports to automatically start receiving internet access because they are going to be receiving a brand new IP address from our X68 Deco router. So now let's go ahead and continue the setup. We've already done this step. We've checked our modem. It's solid. It's green. And we're going to go ahead and wait. And you're going to see it's going to ask you to turn on your Wi-Fi. Once we enable Wi-Fi, the Deco is going to ask for your location. So I like to choose the while using the app option. And it's going to help you connect to the actual Deco device itself. Keep in mind, I'm still in my basement, standing right next to my first Deco system. From here, I'm going to name my device. In my case, this is my basement. And you're going to see here that it automatically determined what my connection type from my fiber communications ONT box is providing. And in this case, it is a dynamic IP connection with IPTV and VLAN off. At this point, you can go ahead and create your new network. I've created a secondary network so I can understand which new devices are joining my new network. But you can certainly keep your existing one and move on. Once it connects to the Deco, it's going to go ahead and test the connection. At this point, we can add our additional Decos. Let's go ahead and do that now using the wall mounting option. Alright everyone, let's move on to adding more Decos using wall mounting. I found these awesome wall mounts on Amazon for the Deco X68s. This will definitely get the job done. On the bottom of these, it has some wire management so you can coil the wires behind it. Moving to back to my laundry room, you can see I've already mounted it. It's two screws that mounts, and I have the power plug nearby, and I coiled it around the Deco, and here you can see the completed setup. Everything else around it is going to be removed, and the Decos are going to remain. You can do the same for other Decos throughout your home, or just leave it laying near another Ethernet port so you can satisfy the wired backhaul system. Now we can go back to the app, and the first thing you want to do is check for updates for all your Decos. When I set mine up initially, there was a firmware update available, so I went ahead and downloaded the firmware and let it install. It was pretty quick and painless, probably took about 5 minutes. Once you finish the firmware installation and the Decos are back online, then you should be good to go. Now we can go ahead and start testing our new network. Let's go ahead and do that now. Alright, now that we have everything set up, let's go ahead and do our Wi-Fi test. So as you remember before, I was getting about 75 megabits per second down, 67 megabits per second upload, and now you can see we're getting well above that with the Ethernet wired backhaul setup and configuration. Your Decos are going to provide a much faster throughput to all your wireless devices. I'm getting this speed across all my Fire Stick 4K Max devices and my Nvidia Shield Pro, as well as my PS5 and my mobile phone. So there you have it, everyone. The TP-Link X68 Decos have performed flawlessly for me in the last 3 months. I've also integrated the TP Home Shield Pro service for an additional peace of mind. I highly recommend this one, guys. If you're looking into Wi-Fi 6 and you also have a gigabit internet connection and you need more throughput, give this one a try. As always, I hope this video was helpful for everyone. And if you like this video, go ahead and smash the like button and hit subscribe. I'll see you all in the next one.